Hello everyone. Today we will see how arabinose operon regulation happens in prokaryotes, especially in E. coli. The arabinose operon of E. coli codes for enzymes that require to metabolize the sugar arabinose. This operon is another example of catabolite repressible operon. As you can see, there are two operator regions, para-O1, para-O2. Para-O1 operator regulates the transcription from ARA-C gene, and para-O2 regulates transcription lead by ARA-PBAT promoter. ARA-C acts as both positive and negative regulator here, and ARA-PC promoter drives the leftward transcription of ARA-C gene. At cap binding site, cyclic AMP cap binds when glucose levels are low, which turns stimulate transcription. This is an example to show if a protein contains protein binding domain and DNA binding domain, and the protein binds to the same phase of DNA, what is the way these two proteins can interact with each other? So if the DNA is making a loop, these two proteins can interact with each other. But if two proteins are binding to the opposite phases of the DNA, looping out will happen, but these two proteins cannot interact with each other. This example is utilized by arabinose operon. When arabinose is not present, ARA-C monomer binds to O2 and I1 region of the operator, leading to the looping of DNA, which causes RNA polymerase not to bind to the promoter. In this case, repression of the arabinose operon happens. When arabinose is present, it binds to the ARA-C protein, changes its conformation, leading to formation of dimer of arabinose ARA-C protein that binds as a dimer to I1 and I2 region. In addition, when glucose is low, cyclic AMP and CAP complex binds to the cap binding site and stimulate transcription further, which causes derepression of the operon. When level of ARA-C protein is high, it binds to the ARA-O1 operator region, which does not allow the transcription from ARA-PC promoter for ARA-C gene, thus preventing an accumulation of too much of repressor. Hence, a protein which regulates its own expression, the process is called as autoregulation. Thank you for watching this.